Hey guys, this is Dia and welcome back to my channel. So today I will be sharing my top 10 tips about how to care for a baby and a toddler together. This is a situation which is very common, I have realized, but not many people have spoken about it yet on YouTube. So I thought I will be sharing my side of the story before it all gets out of my head because it's still fresh. My toddler is quarter to 3 years and my baby, who is not a newborn anymore, he is almost 10 months old. So while it's still fresh, I want to get it out there so that if you're in a situation like this, it can be helpful to you. So let's get started. So my first tip is about the first week. So this is a time when your body has gone through a lot and you really need rest. Delivery is not an easy thing and your body has suffered a lot. So you really want to rest it out. First couple of days, your baby will sleep like crazy. A newborn sleeps like really like a baby, almost 18 to 20 hours a day. So you really want to make most of it. You want to sleep with the baby, and you can have anybody in the family. If you don't have anybody to take care of your toddler, maybe your husband can take a couple of days of paternal leave and then your husband can look after the toddler. But I would highly recommend you to sleep in the first couple of days and rest it out. Give time to your body to recover. This would be the best thing that you would be doing to yourself. So that's tip number one. So my second tip is to enroll your toddler in a playgroup. And there are two benefits to this. One, your toddler will be learning new things every day and your toddler will be very happy in the playgroup, daycare, whatever you want to enroll your baby toddler into. And the second benefit is you will get a lot of time to do household chores. Even if your toddler goes to the playgroup for around like 2-3 hours, that is more than enough time to get some chores done, cooking, cleaning, self-care. I don't mean self-care like doing your hair, skincare routine, but like taking bath, showering or brushing your teeth, freshening up. All of these are so important. I still sometimes struggle with it. So yeah, all of these things can be done at pace. So tip number three is eating well. Now I know it really doesn't sound like a tip, but if I give my example, I ate around 5 to 7 kgs of cow's ghee, 5 to 7 kgs of gourd. Of course, not as if I was eating ghee or gourd just like that. Add it to your rotis, add it to your veggies. Gourd you can just eat like that. Make laddus, methi laddus. You can find the recipes online and eat well so that you recover, your body recover from the postpartum, from the delivery. And this postpartum food helps you gain strength, and you really need this strength to look after a newborn and a toddler, and there's a lot to be done at home. So you know where I'm going. Rest it out, enroll your toddler so that you get a little bit of time, eat well so that you are up and running to look after a baby and a toddler. So self-care during the first weeks, 6 weeks, is really important. And this is the 6 weeks that you can't really establish a schedule for your baby. So really, you want to look after yourself so that after 6 weeks, you can actually focus on establishing a schedule for the baby, which I will be talking about in a minute. So my next tip is to avoid gassy foods. And I know there is no scientific proof that if whatever you eat during postpartum, your breast milk is affected with that, and as a result, your baby will be affected. But I just listened to my peers, and my mom-in-law played it very safe. No potatoes, no cauliflower, no cabbage, and no urad daal or things like that. No chana daal, so that the baby does not have stomach issues. The first 6 weeks, baby's digestion system is really very, I wouldn't say poor, but it's yet not established. And you really want to take care of what you are eating during the first 6 weeks so that your your baby is not colicky, your baby is not gassy, and your baby is not essentially crying. So in my family, we really take a lot of care what postpartum food we are eating, and that is highly driven because so that baby does not suffer. So I used to basically eat spinach, a lot of greens, spinach, fenugreek, dudhi, which is bottled gourd, and things like that. No bhindi, no potatoes or any gassy food. So taking care of your food will essentially keep you in a safe corner where your baby is not having stomach issues or colic or gassiness, and he's not crying because of that. So that's next tip, no gassy food. So the next one is always have colic drops or the gas drops with you. I bet you'll always need it middle of the night. I used to always have Himalaya's Bonnie Spas with me. Now this is an herbal. It's a herbal colic drops that are available in India. I used to use that, but there was a point when my baby was around a week old and he was very colicky, and these drops weren't working. I tried grape water, even that wasn't working. And then one of the peers, they suggested taking Somba 34, Somba 34, and that's what I tried, because that is a time you really want to try everything if that is helpful for your baby. And this really was, because it eliminates gas, it strengthens the digestion system of the baby, and your baby would cry less. It worked for my baby. I'm not saying it will work for your baby as well. Every baby is different. Every baby's immunity, digestion system is different, but this is what worked for my baby. I will include a photograph of it somewhere on the screen so that you know how it looks. It is easily available in any Ayurvedic store, or I have actually seen it on Amazon India as well. So you can try it out if you want to give it a go. There's no harm. All it has is 34 Ayurvedic ingredients, and it's not going to harm your baby. All you have to do is mix it in 1 ml of water, just a tiny pinch of it, and give it to your baby every night. That's what I did, and thank God it helped me a lot. My baby was not as colicky every night after that. So that's something that I did, and I really swear by it. But if you're not comfortable, just skip it. The next tip is to have a swing. Like, seriously, this is the best thing that you would do to yourself and to your baby. And I don't know how to raise a baby without an Indian swing. And I'm not talking about those automatic swings, because they have like backward to front movement. And what I'm talking about is the Indian ghoriyu, which has like side by side movement. So your baby's eyes go like, you know, left, right, and then your baby actually feels drowsy. So, and I bet you if your baby is like, you know, a drowsy, and you swing your baby for 5 to 7 minutes, I bet you your baby will sleep. And this is really helpful when you want to establish a sleep schedule for your baby. So when your baby is around 6 to 8 weeks, you really want to think about when you want to put your baby for a nap. I used to actually back calculate. So I wanted my baby to go to bed at 9 in the night. That means his last nap should be around, say, 6 to 7, so that 7 to 9 is 2 hours in between. So I used to just back calculate, and I used to do trial and error, and that way I just established 3 nap times. So morning, afternoon, and evening, depending on when I want to put my baby to sleep at night. So that's what I did, and this swing was really helpful. And another thing is, it's also very helpful if you want your toddler and your baby to be in the same room in the afternoon or at night. You can swing the baby and you can pat the toddler. You can nurse the baby, you can pat the toddler. So these are the 2 ways I still use to put my toddler to sleep and my baby to sleep in the same room at the same time. Which brings me to my next tip. which is aligning the sleep schedules, and especially the afternoon sleep schedule, because I assume your toddler is taking only one nap a day, which is the afternoon. So you really want to work on aligning these two nap times for your toddler and the baby, so that even you get a little bit of downtime, you get a little bit of your time, me time, mommy time. That's really important. Whatever you want to do, I personally edit my videos at this time. I sometimes take power nap if you want to take a nap as well. So or it should be just a downtime for you, no work, nothing. You really don't want your baby to sleep, and then once the baby is awake, your toddler to sleep. No, that would be the worst thing you'll do to yourself, because you will never get peaceful time of your own. So this is very important to have to align the sleep time for your baby and toddler, the afternoon one. Okay, one thing that you can do is set up a toddler area. I know it's not always going to work, because you know, many times I have a playroom for my toddler, and I would give a painting or a play-doh or some kind of activity to my toddler, and then I'll go and nurse my baby, and in the flick of the second, my toddler would be crying over like the very trivial thing, like her door is broken or something, like, you know, it never works. But you really want to try it. Maybe when you want to work in the kitchen, your toddler is playing, so not only the nap time for your newborn, but there's a lot of work to be done for a mom, right? The chores, cooking, cleaning and things like that. So try and get your toddler to get into the habit of playing a little bit alone. This will help you a lot. And try and introduce new toys, not everything at the same time, but say one every month. That's what I used to do. I used to buy one toy every month for my toddler, and that's how we have built up this playroom. And because we didn't bought everything all together, it's like, you know, slowly and gradually we have invested into it. So this is something that you can think about as well. So my next tip is it wouldn't seem as important, but for me it has really worked, which is having a positive set of mind. And just think about it, like, you know, if you feel that, oh my god, I am stuck, I am depressed, I have postpartum depression, then that's what you are going to feel, that's how you're going to behave. And when my baby was a couple of weeks old, I used to always think that it can only get better from here each passing day. My baby is going to grow old by one day every day, and he's not going to go backwards, he's only going to go forward, and life is only going to get better. And look at me, I am here when my toddler is quarter to 3 years, my baby is now 10 months, and my baby, actually, he sits, he can sit alone, he can play, he's very playful. My toddler likes to play with my baby. So things are so different. Your life will keep changing at every milestone your baby achieves. That is my next tip, is to have a very positive mindset. If you think it, you can do it. If you think I am stuck in the rut, you definitely are. So be determined. That will just give you a lot of strength to get through this. So that's all about the tips that I had to share. One last thing that I want to touch base is on the challenges of having a newborn and a toddler. And the number one challenge is that your toddler will start behaving like a baby, and your toddler will have jealousy, sibling rivalry, and all of those feelings. And these are the things which are normal. My daughter used to have the same feeling. She used to hit the newborn baby, or sometimes scratch him, sometimes pull his hair. I've gone through all of that. So this sibling rivalry is real. It's not actually sibling rivalry, I should say sibling jealousy is real. Because till yesterday, your toddler was your world, and now there's a new baby in your world, and your toddler just can't see that. They just don't want to share everybody in their life. So this is real. This is a challenge, but the only way to get through this is to explain your baby, and this should be a complete no-no. So whenever that happens for the first time, you have to be very strong in saying to your toddler that this will not be accepted. And you just have to do it over and over and over and over again so that your toddler understands, because that is a toddler life, terrible twos, that they just don't understand things when you say it for the first, second or third time. They need repetition to understand things. So that is one thing. And the second thing is they will definitely start behaving like a baby themselves. So Dhyani was like, she never wanted me to hold her, but now because I'm holding the baby, she wanted me to hold her. And she wanted to, like, even till now, if I put Kushank in the baby walker, she wants to sit in the baby walker. And if I want Kushank to crawl, she starts crawling. And things like that. So they really want to replicate everything that the baby is doing in anticipation that, like, you know, mama will treat her like a baby too, which is okay. So just let her be sometimes. Just let her do things like that. Just treat her like a baby. That's what I do. Sometimes I just let her behave like a baby. I would cuddle her, I would talk to her like a baby, and then she would be, yeah, like, I am important. She, that's what she feels. She, you know, the smile that she gives, the happiness that she has on her face, it is like, you know, that now she's happy and content, and she, like, you know, she forgets about that behavior. She just don't behave like it. It looks a bit weird that why the hell are you behaving like a baby? You're not a baby. Don't say that. You're not a baby and don't behave like a baby. Just let her be. So that is another challenge that you will be facing having a toddler and a baby or a newborn. So mainly there are four challenges. So the toddler behaving aggressive, which I've just covered, that your toddler may try to hit your baby. Then there is this jealousy thing, so which is again which will drive your toddler to hit the baby. So I think aggressive and jealousy goes hand in hand. Then your baby behave, your toddler behaves like a baby. That's another thing. And the last one is your toddler don't want to share anything. So yes, that is a big one. Like, my boy is 10 months now, still my daughter, she doesn't want to share her toys. So that's one thing, and that happens from day one. This is mine, this is don't give it to the baby, give it to me. And every little thing, like even the bib or even the like, you know, things like that, like Dhyani used to give this new blanket to me, these are my clothes and things like that, this is my bottle, don't feed the baby and things like that. So that will happen. They just don't want to share. It's not just the toys, it's everything. So that's another thing. But you just, repetition is the thing. Handle your toddler with patience. Because, oh yes, one big tip. I have been in the situation for 10 months now, and I know what works and what not. And I have tried spanking, I have tried being angry on my toddler, but these are the two things that really doesn't work. What works is you have to be very, very polite to your toddler. Because that's what they want. They want they want your love. And if you give them and encourage them, oh, you are a very good girl. Do you want to be a good girl or a bad girl? She'll always choose good girl. And then you have to explain, good girls do this, good girls don't hit, good girls do that. And Dhyani is so encouraged when I talk to her like this, when I respect her, when I encourage her to do something. And now she knows, like, you know, as soon as I put my baby into the swing for a nap, she will run and get his blanket. She knows that this is her task. She will always go and wee herself in the bathroom, and then she will go and grab an undie, and then she will wear it herself, and then I would go wow, and I will clap, and I will make a big deal about it. So try and make your toddler independent. That will help you so much, like weeing. Just give her a spot, that this is the spot where you can wee yourself. So teach her how to take her undies out, pull them up, and then how to wear her shoes herself. And then things like that, eat herself. It's okay if she doesn't eat a day or two, 3 days. She will eventually do. So now what we do at our lunchtime, Dhyani is eating herself. I am eating and feeding Kushang. So we all are eating at the same time. I don't have to worry about, like, you know, Dhyani not eating or first feeding Kushang and then Dhyani crying, feed me. So make your toddler independent. That is the biggest tip. How can I forget about that? So make your toddler independent. The more you do it, the more it will work in your favor. So I guess I will wrap up this video here, and I really want to shout out one of my subscribers. I don't know if I am pronouncing your name correct. I am so sorry if I'm not. So her name is Khadija Kubra, and she is currently 30 to 34 weeks pregnant, somewhere in between there, and her due date is very soon. And I really wanted to put this video out especially for you, because I know you are very stressed. Even I was very stressed how things would be, how will I be able to manage things myself if I don't have any help. Even if you have help, but you still have to do so much being a mom of a toddler and a baby. So I hope these tips really give you some indication of how life would be, how you can take care of a newborn and a baby, both of them together, while looking after yourself. Like, always remember, you have to be happy, you have to be strong. Not just mentally but physically as well, to take care of your kids. So that's about it. I hope you have a wonderful delivery and a wonderful experience of having a baby and a toddler. Also remember, it's going to be crazy. There are days when you will cry, but just cry it out. Even I do that. You really don't have to cry on anybody else's shoulder. Just cry it out, put it out there, cry alone, cry in front of your baby or whatever. You will feel so relaxed, and the next day you'll be pumped up, you'll be charged. Always think, the first 6 months of my life, of your baby's life, is going to be very tough, and you are prepared for it. The more you prepare yourself, the more you will be able to do it. So good luck with everything. I hope I have helped you in whatever little way that I can. I'll sign off now, and bye for now. Bye. I just wanna hold you, I just wanna look into your eyes and tell you that I want you.